Hello again. And again, we have another Lego store. This time it is a Lego branded store. However, it's a little different in that Japan doesn't have an official Lego store aside from that made by or operated by ClickBrick. ClickBrick Japan is one of the authorized resellers of Lego products here in Japan. So we're about to go into an official Lego branded store that is not official Lego, but they sell Lego stuff. What that basically means, they don't honor any of the Lego promotions, nor do they honor the Lego VIP points. They just sell Lego, that's it. Anyway, they've got a good layout, and I want to take you along with me to see Lego. Let's check it out. Here we are, basic display. Apparently they're trying to promote the boats that they have. Not exactly new sets, but recent. And you see here, come to the other side, see the other window. And you can see they're also promoting the apparel, Lego apparel, so you can get shirts and the like. I do like this shirt right here. This is really cool. Should probably get one. This one here is also not bad, but not everyone understands what Lego is, and here they do know what this is. So I might get one of those. Of course, Lego logo everywhere, and a beautiful Lego display. Unfortunately, this store does not have a pick-a-brick wall, so you're not left with much options to customize your Lego sets. But they do apparently have a posting on what's coming out next and what's new, as you can see here. It's reasonably well organized, well kept. So you can see all the city sets here that I would love to have. Well, maybe not all of them, but most of them. This set here, I would really like to get, but I need to wait because I'm traveling today, so I can't take it home today. Even if, I could buy it, but it doesn't make sense to me to do so right now. A lot of other sets here of interest. Get a good idea here. Some of the prices are a little different here as well, if you can see that. And of course, we have Star Wars sets. Here's a set I would really like to get. And I already have the first run of the Star Wars buildable figures, but the second run I don't have yet, so maybe later this month I'll get those. And of course, Nexo Knights are interesting. They have some really cool parts, but it's a theme that I'm like, well, I'm not so sure about. Nice little display. Here's an interesting one I like. The Jester's Evil Mugler. Of course, more city sets here. Let's come around the corner. They do have a little play area, so if you want to just kind of dig in and grab a little something and just start kind of playing around, you know, so you can just sort of enjoy your time here. Good that they have these road plates. And nice little display here of different assortment of, let's see, looks like you have the research boat. And a little bit of Mixel, almost. And got a mix of things here. Mostly city and a little bit of Speed Champions. And of course we have the shuttle. Let's come back around here. There's a gorgeous display of the treehouse set from the Friends line. Again, I have to say, I love the Friends Treehouse playset. And of course, good selection of Friends. So if you want anything from the Friends theme,
definitely come to a Lego store. I'm liking this one mostly because of the large windows that I could use. It'd be great for making skyscrapers and high-rise towers. I think this is the cafe.
Yeah.
Cupcake Cafe. And this little adventure camp looks pretty cool. Now this one I like because of the balloon pieces. You don't get many of these specialized pieces like that, and this is a good set to get this in. And I certainly want this nice hotel, Heart Lake Hotel, down here at the bottom. This will be good to have. A nice little add-on to it as well.
To the Heart Lake Town,
which is all part of the French theme. Let's come around here. All right, you got your basic stuff. Juniors, right here. And someone took a basic or a classic set and just started building some of it. A little bit of elves. Apparently they don't have that much in elves here. The selection's rather sparse. But they do have a little bit more on the Disney princess, which is nice. Around this way, see more of the Disney display sets. You can see there's a lot of heavy emphasis on the Snow Queen. Oh, they even have one for Ariel here at the bottom. Very cool. Alright, now we have basic accessories. So if you want some watches, what have you. I guess we're kind of out of luck when it comes to getting any minifigures today. Oh wait, never mind, I see them. Alright. Now we have minifigures. I have enough of these. Probably too many of these actually. Simpsons, Series 2. And your Series 14 sets here. And your basic keychain accessories and other stuff here. Magnets. Alright, let's come around here and look at some of the technique stuff. Here's one that I'd like to get. Actually, I think I have this one coming soon. This would be great to have. Add this to my collection of motorcycles I have already. Look at the superheroes. Through here. And more superheroes. And they actually have this humongous Big Fig. Now this one I'd be interested in just for the Big Fig only. And maybe the airplane, but alright, maybe because I like Iron Man and Captain America, I might get this set as well. That might be fun. But coming back to one of my bigger interests, and that's Technique Lego. Definitely want to get this here. And what I'd like to do with it is use the education set, maybe replace the rotors with the education rotors, and then actually see if I can get it to fly. That would be fantastic. Alright. Definitely want to pick this one up right here, combine it with this here, as they do combine together to make a very fast wind-up toy. Well, wind-up car. Of course, I want this one as well, and I think I have this one coming soon. And of course, I really like this really big technique set. Let's come over here to the wall, see some of the creator and architecture stuff. Again, for me, I'm not big on architecture, but they have a pretty good selection here. Come down not too fast. And it looks like we have one of the smaller modular builds here. Creator stuff. Cool. Very good. Looks like they have one of the half modules here. Okay. And Ninjago, another set that I have that has grown onto me rather strongly. I find that I like this one a lot, especially the theme. If you watch the animated series, you understand more of the story and the design inspirations for which they are building upon these sets. So I really think these would be interesting to use as maybe rotor pieces for a helicopter, or maybe a VTOL type drone that you can build. So that's something I want to experiment with on these pieces here. Maybe even get all the different colors to go with it. Dragon set looks really cool, along with these mechs. I think these mechs would be a lot of fun to have. And of course, the ship here would be really cool to have as well. And we come up here and we find Speed Champions. Speed Champion stuff. This one I saw a review on and I thought would be really cool, especially how it opens up. Unfortunately here they don't have it opened up where you can really see anything, which is rather unfortunate. I thought they really should just kind of flip it around so you can see more inside, but they're not doing that here for whatever reason. Anyway, there's a lot of really cool stuff set up on the inside of this, and they have like a computer set up where you can see the metrics on how good the racer is going. And they've done a pretty good job on how they put this together and make it look realistic. So that I can appreciate. Not to mention good parts. Lots of good red parts. Alright, back to Ninjago. You can see the dragon set coming along here. Alright, let's come over here to the corner. And of course, the big so-called UCS set. Well, it is officially UCS, it actually says so. But yes, this would be a really good one to have, and I definitely want this one. Just, again, not practical to buy today, simply because I have to travel outside of Tokyo, and I'm not going home anytime today. Here's another set I have a good amount of interest in. I would like to have one of these to build. It represents a barge park that's near Tokyo Disneyland here. And so this would be good to have in my own little home city to represent the Ferris wheel that they have in Chiba. Alright. These are kind of cool. They remind me of the team model builds for Technique a bit. Oh wow, they actually got the Simpsons sets in. And wow, these boxes are huge. Now that I look at them, very cool. I like the Quickie Mart. Well, it's a nice little detail on the inside here that would be great to have. Of course, some of the ideals, we have a couple ideal sets here that I think will be great. I like the Doctor Who set, I have this one. The architecture set, now this one I would probably get mostly for all the different pieces and the excellent book that they have. That would be great. Of course, I got this one for my wife, and she loves birds, so this one was really good purchase for her. This one looks like it'd be really cool, but I'm not sure it fits with the architecture or this theme that I would want to show for my city, but then again, lots of nice pieces here. Great techniques. Here's a good favorite set of mine right here, the Ninjago set. I happen to like this one quite a bit, although here, the price is quite expensive here, actually. It was far cheaper for me to buy this on BrickLink and have it shipped to me than it was to buy it here. In the States, it costs like $200. Here, it's like $100 more. And even with shipping, it was cheaper to have it shipped from the US to here. So
It's up to you guys. If you want the Ninjago set, either join a lug and have them buy it, or get it from US. Same thing for Mindstorms. I like the idea behind Mindstorms, and I really like the concepts that they encourage and the pieces that it comes with, especially the big smart brick right here. But the price is outrageous, in my opinion. It's almost twice as much. In the States, I can get it for about $350. Here, it's almost twice that. So it doesn't make sense to really buy it here. It makes sense to order it through a lug or have it shipped from the U.S. All right, and here's some apparel they have hanging down here. Let's come around here to this corner. You can see some of the accessories and other little things that they offer. Of course, I had to get some of these I Love Tokyo Reagan sets. Those are great. I have one on my refrigerator right now. And of course, I've been thinking about picking up one of these, but I really want one that's meant like hot drinks. And this doesn't, to me, I don't think of hot drinks when I look at these Friends type of Lego cups. And of course, we have some of the storage type of boxes. We have the little lunch Obento boxes here with the Lego shape. Just so you know, they are not stackable. It's a flat bottom, so you can't really stack them. So if you're looking to use these as a large type of Lego block, it doesn't really work. It's the same as these other little Lego boxes they have. They're not stackable. The bottom here is flat. Prices, however, are decent on these points. Of course, you get the little miniature, little mini boxes that are basically the same thing. And here we have the actual Lego dolls that I was not aware of before. They look kind of interesting, but not something I'm really interested in. Here we are, another little clock here. And of course, we have Mixels. Mixels has some really interesting parts to them. And I'm especially interested in these little hinges they have right here. Really small hinges, but they work really well. You can pose them very nicely. They have really good clutch power. You can do a lot with these, especially when you're wanting to make some really dynamic builds. Now here's one little Lego figure I wish was for sale, because I want it. And I hear they're quite expensive if you don't have one. You could have got one, say, maybe 10 years ago. Maybe I'll ask the store if it's for sale. And a few other little displays here. Okay, come around here, look at the keychain wall. They give you an assorted set of keychains that you can look through. A lot of Friends here. To my surprise, they actually still have the Hermione keychain. It looks like Hermione. From the Harry Potter series theme. I guess she wasn't too popular here. Bit of Ninjago, Kima, Basic City, classics, a little Star Wars. And of course, they have a build a minifigure area here where you just simply come inside here and just sort of dig around and find something you like. For all you Lego fans, enjoy this sound for a moment. Music to the ears. Okay. All right. Come around here. Show you a little bit of Duplo for you guys who are interested in Duplo sets. Of course, the larger classics. I have one of these and has a lot of great bricks in them. Some of the bricks I was not expecting are also available in here, so you can get a good idea. Here are the bricks that it does have, so I'll leave it here so you can pause on it and see what bricks you might like. All right.
course, here's the junior set. So you show you the back of this one as well. All right. So this is sort of a castle theme one that you can see. Duplos. Now, as you can see here from this display here, just like they show you, you could use a regular brick and a Duplo brick quite easily. The basic shape is double, so you can put, as you can see here, clutches on reasonably well. And you can configure this any kind of way you want. As you can see here, regular Lego on top of Duplo. And show you for the bottom as well.
Sorry, looks like I dropped it.
Okay. So turn this on the bottom so you can see the basic theme shape. And as you see here, not too bad. And likewise, right here. Now the biggest problem with Duplo, and this is actually by design, the clutch power is a lot lower. So if you're building large mods, these are great if you have a way to ensure that they don't really come apart, and essentially you surround them with all the regular Lego, or you have some kind of structure to keep them in place. Otherwise, they'll just simply fall apart. And this is by design because children, are, especially young children for which this theme is expected to be played with, they don't expect to have the same strength that an older child would have, so it makes sense that the clutch power would be a lot lower. But nevertheless, the great thing, as you can see here obviously, if you look at the size, by part value, if you get the larger of these Duplo bricks, you could build really large mocks. It's really large collection and creations make it possible to use fewer pieces of your very valuable and expensive Lego blocks and just use Duplo instead for the internal structure of your large mock. So if you're building a big mountain or something like that and you have to cover a lot of volume, these can help you cover that volume quite nicely. Alright. Here are the rest of the Duplo stuff that they have available. Now, I'm not going to go into this too detailed as I had with the rest of them. They do have some of these other Lego figures I just love to have in my Lego closet. And they have a little play area over here, which I'm just sort of going to glance over a bit. Alright, guys.
So I hope you enjoyed this tour of the Lego store. This store is located in the AEON Outlet Mall that's located in Saitama, Koshigaya. So if you ever want to come out here, please do. Visit the store and have a blast. Catch you in the next video.